Hello guys, so welcome to today's show. My name is CHUKS and you're on JFL TV, the home of football. So if today that the first time we see our program, we're able to bring you the latest Arsenal news updates as they drop all over the world. So for now, I'm going to start with today's show. So cut offside, when they let us know, say Arsenal, they're interested in signing RB Salzburg playmaker Oscar Glock. Or Gulok, I don't know why I want to pronounce the name. So they say Arsenal interested. Nobody asked them, the people they find the guy. They say exclusive story: Arsenal, Newcastle, Aston Villa among transfer suitors for €35 million playmaker. Now, when you read the entirety of this report, you're going to find out say they say all these people they show strong interest in the potential transfer of the playmaker Oscar Gulok. Now, who is valued around $35 million. Now, sources with a close understanding of the player's situation have informed Cut Offside that Arsenal, Villa are all keen admirers of this particular player. See, they like the way the guy they perform, they do many things. So, me, say, based on I know really they follow RB Salzburg, so I can't run go check this guy performances. Like, what's so special about him? Maybe say Arsenal they go for him. So, I can't discover say last season. He got 7 goals and 11 assists, which is like 18 goal contributions in 29 games. This is already 7 games. He already scored 5 goals, give 2 assists. So I can see why Arsenal and all these people, they actually go for the player. So further down the report, they say Arsenal, Oscar Glock transfer. Could we see him move to Arsenal, Newcastle? Are they to sanction this deal? When you do that report, it gets part of the report where they talk, say, the reason Arsenal are currently struggling, that from the second paragraph, Arsenal are currently struggling without the injured Martin Odegaard, so might have room for another creative midfielder to come in, with the likes of Newcastle, Villa, surely have be attempted to keep an eye, keep on strengthening. See, what this shows is that Arteta don't really get that much confidence in Ethan Nwaneri, sadly. It doesn't mean the player is not good, but Arteta just feels he's not ripe. You know, they like he never did good enough to start now. And many Arsenal fans have a different view when it comes to this player. Many Arsenal fans feel they're supposed to restart him. And me, I'm a strong advocate of playing him in games like that Bournemouth game, for example. Now, Charles Watt said, you know, with the surprise if them play, it will make sense. Me too, I subscribe to that line of thought. So, okay, if you know if you plan for Bournemouth, China against Liverpool, Shakhtar Donetsk, PSG, Manchester City, now one country play, all those kind of games, you foresee try and but the onus still lies with the manager, and we have to respect the manager's wishes. We can only criticize him constructively. You get, don't say you constantly insult Arteta. No. You have to, because if you do bad, now you go fire. Don't be made to go fire now, Arteta. So, in as much as the lineup Arteta they put out, we don't like it, you still have to respect his decisions, because at the end of the day, if we lose, now they collect all the flack. Don't be me and you, they collect the blame. So, it's just obvious that Arteta doesn't really trust the boys. Some people bring the argument of, if you don't really trust them, why you allow the likes of Fabi Vieira to leave? So, Arteta just, like Arteta never envisaged. Say, when season will start, Odegaard will go a lengthy injury, when they try to put Trossard, all those kind of things. So, as Emekai clear the air, so we are now looking at getting a new creative player, because nobody saw this coming. Say for this season, Odegaard will go injury, and the way the injury they go, how many matches don't miss now? Nobody saw this coming. So we'll see January, maybe they'll come forcefully bringing somebody. Now, away from that, I checked the comment section yesterday after the evening show. Oh, talk about what happened for Chelsea with Tosi Adarabioyo and Lewis Colwill and Saliba and Ben White. I saw so many conversations. I don't engage some people in some intellectual discussion. We did some arguments because I try to let people know, say, okay, the two incidents are not the same. People say they are the same. So today now, I still not point though, but I say, talk about them once more. Make I show now something, because I think people are focusing on a different thing. Now, when they focus on Saliba and Evan Nelson and this Tosin Adarabioyo, now there when they focus, those two foul are the same. The foul is the same. But where the difference? Nambi, look at the position of where Lewis Colwill did in close proximity to Tosin. Look at the position of Ben White where in day in close proximity to our own player Saliba. You can see, the context of the two situations are not the same, but the foul is the same. And that is why when the referee look at our own case, ab initio, the referee first gives Saliba a yellow card. before they come look and say, but nobody there in close proximity to even catch the player. So the FA, the referee, the VAR, the decision are subjective decision in the sense that themselves they speculate, because when you are doing subjective decision, you go they speculate, you go they assume things when they for evidence. Now, for our own case, the FA they assume say, if to say Saliba no fall the player, then maybe Saliba fisty no catcher, you get, or the boy go wrong go. If Saliba no fall out, so the boy go wrong go. Now the assumption be that. At the same time, they don't say, okay, maybe Ben White self fit to no stick catch him. That one the assumption. For Chelsea own, that they assume, say, if to say that guy no touch him, maybe they will call with fist to catch him, or the guy fist to catch him. So everything, Baba, now in the realm of speculation. So you when they talk, say, the FA, the referee, they're wrong. You say, if they speculate, because Aston fans, they see this thing as say, Ben White fist to catch him, because Ben White gets straight road. You might be right, you might be wrong, but the Coco be say, all of us, they speculate. Now, so many of my senior men, they enter my DM, we're talking about this incident. They're going to tell me, CHUKS, sometimes you should cater to the sensibilities of Aston fans. Tell them what they want to hear. Follow them and say, the FA is wrong. But the thing is, I'm not built that way. You get? If you watch, they don't lose that match. I'm not doing even a show because emotionally, I was not in the right frame of mind. So if I can't do the show, I feel they talk rubbish. That's why I just take a break. My affairs calm down, because that day I was mad. I was livid. I was crazy. You remember, I don't even show that day. I just go relax. Even the full-time analysis show was 4 minutes because I was not in the right frame of mind and I cannot be analyzing things when I'm emotionally, like, bias will involve. So for this same case, see, there are two things now. It is either we want the referees to follow things to the letter of the law. The law is the law, like people, they talk. Or we allow them use their discretion. If we say, make them use their discretion, understand, say, that discretion within they use, Ojoro go enter. The discretion, that subjective reasoning, they're not going to look at things objectively. Now, what you need to understand, that's why sometimes you get some decisions where we say the referees do subjectively with favors. Look at the match you played against Leicester. Calafiri could have collected the second yellow that led to a red. But the referee said, no, I'm not giving. Even Bonuanate, the player of Leicester, protested. It's not clear for her, Baba. You don't go give her yellow. The referee say, you're not going to tell me how to do my job. Referee give her yellow card instead. Alan Shearer, after that match, come outside the palace. Aston escape. Aston was supposed to win 4-2. That they own with yellow. That is where discretion comes into play. Now, that same discretion, sometimes it will go against your favor. Whether right or wrong. The FA, they speculate. Where will they speculate? At the end of the day, the regulators will get the final say. Now, like I was telling one of my senior men, I said, why don't we look at the root cause? Everything when they talk, it ain't right to. But on our own way, when they look at it, it ain't right to. But at the end of the day, understand that we are all speculating when we are using our discretion. None of us, they look at things objectively. Subjective decisions go enter. And when it enters, it can go your way or it may not go your way. That's what it just be. Let's look at the root cause. Why Saliba don't let that guy go? Maybe Saliba for stick catcher. Maybe Ben White for stick catcher. Why not look at the root cause? If to say then give Calafiri a red card, it will be 4 red cards in 8 games, but they don't give Calafiri your own. Something is going on, like what's been Declan Rice said. Something is going on that we need to fix, and Arteta needs to talk to these boys. If we continue like this, we know if we win the league. So, my final say on this matter be say, let us let sleeping dogs lie. Let us face fronts. Let us ensure that this will be the last time we are doing this. All of us, they talk about conspiracy. They're not like us now. I agree with you that there is a conspiracy. But why are our players putting us in a position where the people who we say hate us, who can't get chance to do a strong thing, to can't use subjective decisions enter us? Why are we not looking from that angle? Even though we give them the excuse of response to stimulus action, say they know when they do this thing, they just do and before they can't think and but we can't continue like this. The conspiracy is clear. We know that. But the referees, they are still under the ambits of the law with that subjective reasoning. Remember, this season, how would we come as I talk, say, you don't give the referees VR the leeway to apply their discretion. They are not asked to be following the rules to the letter of the law. You get it. Now, they are the issue there. So it is either we want the law to be the law, no matter whose ox is God, or we want them to use their discretion. And remember, when they use their discretion, it can go against you. You get another referee, where you go be. This same thing will happen to Tosin. Tosin go call a red. You get another VAR, where you go be. This same thing happened to Tosin. Tosin go collect red. You get another VAR and referee where he go be. This will happen to Saliba. That on-field decision now will stand. VAR not going to intervene. It all goes back to subjective reasoning with discretion. So I believe this is clear enough for everybody to understand how the thing take go down. Even said the London Evening Standard. How come I can't make Ricardo Calafiori red card admission? That might be the one I had to tell at that time. See, we say we jello, you get for that one. Now subjective reasoning. We say we enjoy him. Maybe they're supposed to give a Calafiori second yellow. Alan Shearer come aside, they slam, they talk, this and that. Now, former EPL referee, can they explain why he himself feels say Saliba red card is supposed to happen? This is McHalsey. Now, McHalsey put out a very nice position. So they say former Premier League referee McHalsey believe VAR shouldn't have intervened to award William Saliba a red card during 2-0 loss against Bournemouth. I agree with this. I agree. But the thing is, subjective decisions, as long as they don't give them that leeway to use that discretion. One VAR, I think, come as I talk, say, but Saliba don't get anybody way near him now. So why not go give a yellow? Make him now upgrade him to red. Another VAR, physically come as I talk, say, oh, that yellow card don't they okay. No issue. So as long as we are in the realm of discretion, using discretion, you're going to see all these things as they happen. The sad part, we say, now, last night, they happen to the most. That's why all of us, they cry foul, say, you're not supposed to be like this. So that's why I subscribe to what McHalsey is saying, that the VAR should not have been involved. But it's just sad. It's just quite sad. Now, even Football London, they explain why Tosin Arabi Ayo wasn't sent off versus Liverpool. And I said the same thing about the difference now, the position of Ben White and the position of Levi Colwill. That's just the different position. That's why they don't even bother to send John Brooks to the monitor. The difference from the Arsenal and Saliba strike is just the defenders around him. So I believe the situation is clear. It is a sad thing. It's a sad pill to swallow because the company, like I say, the conspiracy is too high. Now we then carry for mind. But it is what it is. Let our players try their utmost best not to put us in positions like this. Now, after everything, Thomas Partey only demand for Arsenal teammates to listen to Mikel Arteta's warning after the bomb multiple because enough is enough. We cannot continue like this. For the denial of goal scoring opportunity, we look at four key criteria. That's for Skada, where we say, like, and they say, this I think is still on the McHalsey situation. But Thomas Partey kind of talks, okay, so they don't look at all the carcass of the Arsenal unbeaten run after a damaging defeat at Bournemouth and warned we must learn from our mistakes. But after the Gunners start sending off in six Premier League games, the penny still hasn't dropped. Is stuck in the slot machine. Moving on, Papa said you can't win the title with 10 men. And if Arsenal don't hit the manager, Mikel Arteta's advice, may they cut all this red card down. Papa, only God knows that the next match against Liverpool, we still go collect another red card. Now, Thomas Partey said we have to learn from our mistakes and not let them happen again. We are working hard. We are trying to win our duels. And sometimes these things happen. We have to stick together because red cards can happen in games and we must learn from every mistake. Every time we have 11 players on the pitch, we always dominate the game. I agree. We never play 11-11 more could lose like this season. Look at all the games who will drop points. One man down. Man City, Brighton, this one, that one man down must involve. You get so I subscribe to the line of thoughts of waiting party the talk. Now, the funniest thing we have over the weekend, now be Aaron Ramsdale, Papa, the celebrity Bournemouth beats Arsenal. And it will shock me. So they say Aaron Ramsey's dad had expressed his delight at AFC Bournemouth's shock 2-0 victory over Arsenal on Saturday. Now, after the match, Baba composed for Twitter when they say, back of the net, Boscombe. So when I saw this post, I said, which one be Boscombe? Who be Boscombe? So first of all, I'm going to talk about the intent. What did they make Aaron Ramsey Papa the vex? So they say, you know, like the way they take Poshun picking for Arsenal, because we did not have a clue that Ramsey was going to be dropped for David Raya. Ramsey's dad told the Highbury Squad podcast in November last year, I didn't have a clue, our family didn't have a clue, Aaron didn't have a clue that he was not going to carry on playing. So now that one, I vex him. Now, what in this Boscombe mean? So Baba post, back of the net, Boscombe. So Boscombe, that chant where AFC Bournemouth fans, they use, and they reference the club's original name. They were once called Boscombe FC before. That's why I come the as the Daily Mail, when they do an extensive report, where they call it toxic, Arsenal must eradicate ill discipline if they are going to get their title bid back on track after William Saliba sending off Cost Gunners in Bournemouth defeat. Aysan Khan, then be the reporter, who they write all these things. And what he's saying is correct, because they say, what's in the talk show? They're correct. So I don't think there's any place we're going to argue. I think this slide comes from the guy where Arsenal once signed. It'll be 35 million. I think I don't already tell now about the price. They asked and they're interested in signing them. So we'll enter another report from 90 minutes. So 90 minutes going to put out another fantastic report. See, Arsenal, they don't hand them a huge boost in the race to sign Antoine Semenyo. Now, Semenyo going to confess saying be Arsenal fan. I never saw this coming yet. So he's going to explain, going to talk, say, I'm an Arsenal fan. The Bournemouth forward was telling The Athletic, I don't conflict the two with my job. That because I'll be Arsenal fan, if I can't play Arsenal, I know I can't play well. No, I don't conflict that thing. There's no conflict of interest. It is great to play Arsenal against teams. No, to play against Arsenal, a team I have watched all my life, and I want to play for the top clubs as well. In order for that to happen, I need to prove it. Whether joining a club like Arsenal is his overall dream, Semenyo continued. Yeah, any team that plays in the Champions League and Europa League, obviously, that's the aim. You would like to join them. You get so. That's what it just be. Now, the London Evening Standard, when you look at three different ways where Arsenal fit play without Saliba against Liverpool. That's three different ways they can line up without Saliba. Now, the first lineup, Ben White, Calafuri, Gabriel Magalhães, and Timber. This lineup, for me, it no work. I think I spoke about this thing yesterday. Because White come for center back. White and Gabriel Magalhães can play center back. Then Calafuri and Timber can So that's the only way with me. I know, see, now we never even know the status of Tomiyasu. Whether Tomiyasu said, don't come back. Because I hear somebody in the mention says, actually, you talked about Tomiyasu. So we don't know whether that one safe. Don't come back. Whether in the available. So we don't really know. Then another possible lineup now, Thomas Partey right back, then White, Gabriel, and Calafuri. That's assuming say team by never come back. The problem we will get with this one is say Partey go there faced with the likes of Luis Diaz. And Luis Diaz versus Partey, Omoyen go lick Partey like a pot of soup. Unless Akako on the track back. Like, I don't like it go hard. It go hard for Partey to contain that player. Apart from that, the final one now, White, Timber, Gabriel, Calafuri. Now, this one, the talk say Timber staying in that center back position, Timber shots. So, Omo, that place will be like shots one because Cross Arnold go plenty. Because you have a Trent Alexander Arnold, you have a Robinson, they can't get Darwin Núñez with it there. Cross Arnold go plenty now. So, another area, I would say we need to look, but more just to watch from the Champions League match we'll play tomorrow against Shakhtar Donetsk. From there, we'll get a semblance of who don't come back, who never come back. So when that happens, then we'll know what will happen for the weekend. So my dear lovers, like usual, if you're enjoying the show, don't forget to like the content, subscribe, share, and follow us. And if you do so, thumbs up to you. Now, the biggest news of the day. Now, the fact say Arsenal, according to Cut Offside and many other reports, they talk say Arsenal they're interested in signing RB Salzburg playmaker, what they call Oscar Glück. So we're interested in signing the guy. So the guy, I can go check his statistics. The guy said if they play very well, this guy is going to be costing £35 million. So what would they hear? And is open to a move to the Premier League. The guy they play very, very well. Now, when you look at the statistics for RB Salzburg last season, in 29 games, the guy get like 18 goal contributions, 7 goals, 11 assists, and then they play Champions League. And the guy, this is already 7 games, he's already scored 5 goals and 2 assists. That is why Arsenal they reason the guy. So let's just see. Because from the look of things, I think I don't get confidence of where it's a 180 day, sadly. So we'll see what will happen at the end of when January don't reach. We'll see whether Arsenal go for the guy. So, my dear Arsenal lovers, I think this is a fine place for us to call the show an end. So, it's come your way in the evening to give you the evening news. So, then thanks for tuning in. Enjoy the rest of your day. Nadia Mouse. All right, guys. Bye bye.